Making money with children's books all starts with having a good quality story. In a previous video, I hired three ghostwriters from Fiverr to write three different early reader chapter books for me. I'll give you a link to that video in a bit. Now, I've since hired three children's book editors to edit those stories. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I found those children's book editors, what specs we agreed on, and how they did editing a children's book. So whether you've written your own children's book or you've had one ghostwritten for you, if you want to start making money with children's books, then today's video on hiring an editor is for you. Now with that, let's jump right in. Well, here we are on Fiverr. And if you head on over to kwheelerbooks.com/Fiverr store, it'll take you to where I'm at right now, which is what I like to call the author store, because the entire store is based on the different steps of publishing and promoting your book. Kind of focus on what you're looking for, and so that way you're not overwhelmed by all the different options that are on Fiverr. So they've got content editing, proofreading, beta reading. So if you're looking for beta readers, you can check out over here and see what options they have. But we're gonna go to content editing. And as you can see right now, there's over 1,200 services available. And so I wanna narrow it down a bit. And as you can see, you can filter on the different genres. But if you click on this, where it says more, right here they have children's books. Okay, so that automatically dropped it down to 217, but let's narrow it down a bit more. Now I'm gonna pick three different editors for these three books that we have, so one editor for each. You can filter on whether you want top rated, level two, level one, or new sellers. I'm actually gonna leave this open because I'm open to the different possibilities, because I understand that even though someone may be a new seller, that doesn't mean they're new to editing, they're just new to Fiverr. I'm gonna scroll down here where it says seller speaks, and I wanna stick with people that speak English. Okay, so 205 services, and that includes ads. So I literally just go through like we've done on previous videos, and I'm just gonna click on each one and learn a little bit more about what they offer, what their prices are. And I want to find someone who is like at the lower end of the pricing, someone in the middle, and then someone a little bit higher up. So right here, I can see what their overall rating is. I can see how many they have, how many ratings they have. So 678, and how many orders in queue. Again, we've covered this in the previous videos that I've done, but that's good to know. So that way, you know, if you are in a time crunch, you might want to pay attention to the number of orders in queue. This is what I like to focus on. I like to read what they wrote in there about this gig. This lets me know, or at least gives me an idea as to how well their grammar is, how well their English is. And then after I'm done reading that, and I can see what genres they work in, then I'm gonna look at the different gigs that they have available. So for this particular one I clicked on, it only has one option. This person's got a couple, let's just click on this one, okay? I do like that this says very clearly, open door policy, even after your order has been completed, I pride myself on my relationships with my clients, I will always be someone you can trust and rely on. That tells me a lot about their character. So let's look at what their different gigs are. So this one's for 500 words. That's not what I need, because my books are 2,500. Okay, so the closest one they have is this one for 2,000, and it includes voice and tone consistency, structure edits, developmental edits, that's good, proofreading, line editing, and review and critique. So that's good, because a lot of times you're gonna get people who will only do line editing or only do proofreading. You guys have requested, I will do a video on the different types of editing. But for now, it's nice to know that this person will do all of them. What I will do next, and even if, because as you can see, this doesn't really cover exactly what I'm looking for, I will go down to contact seller. Even if they have a gig that's exactly what I'm looking for, I still contact the seller first. Basically what it'll do is it'll open up a messaging system within Fiverr, and I'll just reach out to them and tell them a little bit about my project and kind of get a feel for the pricing they can do, the timing that they can do depending on what they have in queue and the complexity of my project, and just to see if it's a fit. Now this one in particular, I know a lot of people that write children's books like to do rhyming, and this is one thing that they focus on too. It doesn't really say it down here, but I just noticed that this says rhythm and rhyming. So that's good to know that you've got someone that's gonna not only edit your book for typos and grammar issues and stuff like that, but they're also gonna look at the rhythm and rhyming that you've done in your book. So if your book does rhyme, this is a good type of thing to look for in your editors. Again, I'm just gonna go through and click on a couple others and see what I can find. And I'm not going to bore you with all that. So we're going to do a quick switch and I'm going to show you what I came up with. First, we're going to go with Sam J. Ones with 5-star reviews, 125 reviews in total, only has one order in queue right now. The offer that they have is that we already saw is only 2,000. So again, I reached out to them and she's going to do it actually for $150. So as you can see, here's the offer that she sent me, $150, it's one revision, 2-day delivery, and all the different types of editing they're going to do. And again, it's for 2,500 words. So I'm actually going to go in right now and I'm going to click continue and confirm and pay. Next up is Rose Barlow, 4.9 overall rating, 884 reviews. I reached out to them and they came back and said that they would do it for $100. Confirm and pay. Now, last but certainly not least, the actual last person I went to is Editor Krista, the one that we saw to begin with. You know, I reached out to her. She agreed to do it for, because as you saw, the other ones are 100 and 150. I wanted to find one that was a little bit lower in pricing. And she actually agreed to do it for $35 with, a 2-day turnaround. So I'm going to go in, click continue, confirm and pay. Now, after I confirmed and paid with all of them, the detailed came up where each one's a little bit different, where basically the requirements that they're looking for, where they ask for the file, a little bit of extra information depending on the particular gig. Then we just wait until we hear back from them and we get the first edited files. Okay, so I've gotten all the projects back, all the editing is done, and here's what I found about these three children's book editors from Fiverr. The first one was Krista. She was the one with the custom order of $35. And I gave her the aviation story. The first thing is she turned it around in 24 hours, which was a day earlier than she originally projected. Next, she provided proofreading and minor edits, and she used track changes. She also provided some thoughtful questions and suggestions, like using larger words where appropriate, as well as made verbiage suggestions, depending on whether my target audience was in the US or abroad. Now, lastly, she even included a PDF file on how to use track changes for those people who are unfamiliar, which I thought was a nice little add-on. Now overall, her gig, like I said, was only $35, so she didn't allow for any revisions or anything like that. But for the $35 price, I thought the value she added was quite good. Next up was Rose Barlow. Now hers was the $100 gig, and I gave her the detective mystery story. She provided the first draft of edits in 1.5 days, which was still ahead of schedule. She provided both an edited marked up copy as well as a clean finished file. She used track changes as well. Now, one of the questions that she asked me as a follow-up was whether or not I was looking for US English or UK English. And I really appreciated this as it showed her understanding of the differences between the audiences. Now, I accepted most of her edits as well as made some additional tweaks myself, and then I sent it back for a second edit. She turned that second one around in less than half a day and I accepted it. Everything was great. Again, well worth the $100. Now, Sam Jones, that was a different story. This one was the most expensive at $150, and so I gave her the fantasy story. I'm gonna be honest, she blew me away. It was honestly amazing. First, she delivered the gig on time, actually 3 hours early. Now, I will be honest, she only provided me one file using track changes, unlike the last one, Rose Barlow, who gave me a finished file and an edited file, but that was minor. It wasn't requested, so it was just an added bonus that Rose gave that Sam Jones didn't. But let me tell you, the other stuff that Sam Jones did, like I said, really blew me away. The edits that she made were amazing. She not only made minor edits, like replacing a comma here and there with an em-dash, but she made structural edits, edits to tie in more continuity to the overall storyline, as well as numerous suggested rewrites, sometimes for an entire paragraph, all of which were welcome changes. She even gave examples of alternate ways to handle things in the writing, like instead of using quotes for when the character was thinking, use italics. She made suggestions based on Chicago Manual style of writing, like spelling out numbers that are less than 100 instead of using the numeric versions. Now, just to be clear about the suggested rewrites, she didn't just suggest I do a rewrite. She actually provided the rewrite that she was suggesting. Then at the bottom of the file, she provided a detailed overall feedback section. This feedback started off almost like a book review, but then she included more detail about the overall story, including a summary of the types of edits that she made. She even provided a list of frequency of words in the story. Then when I went in and made those changes, She did another round of edits, and that was turned around in probably about half a day. And she even offered, after I completed the gig and accepted it, if I had any additional changes, she was willing to edit it again. So like I said, Sam Jones blew my mind with the quality that she gave me. And again, that was the most expensive one, but it was $150, which I think is $150 well spent. Now, regardless of your budget, I'm pretty sure that one of the children's book editors I worked with can help you out. And I'll include a link to each of them down in the description below. Now, while I definitely have my favorite, I'd be happy to work with any of these children's book editors again. Now, our next step is to hire a children's book illustrator. Since these stories are early chapter books, I won't be using the same exact parameters as I did when I was hiring a children's book illustrator. But I did do this series right here where I tested out and hired some picture book illustrators from Fiverr. I even had my viewers pick the winner to do my entire book. Now, if you've already seen that series, well, YouTube says that this video right here is perfect for you. I catch you in one of those videos, and remember to write right.